Yeah. Welcome to the Real 11 Basketball Show. Yeah, yeah.
You know that new dance coming up. Run away, I'll carbon beam, nope. Knock your
layers off. Oh. How you doing? Had to stand off. Hey. Hit him in the spine. Hey. Knock your dreads off. Hey. What is it called? I didn't name them. She been practicing all week for that.
Don't do that. You just mad because you can't dance. These songs there you out go. Here is ridiculous. All these challenges. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Real Loving Basketball. I am Lee Tao.
Yeah, and I'm D Tao. And we are your hosts of the Real Loving Basketball, powered by Conquering Purpose.
Oh, we throwing that in there now.
Yeah, you know, we're doing the production, man. You know, man. Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
What's up, y'all? How y'all doing? How you doing, first and foremost, man?
I am busy as usual. We are in season for high school. We got CTAP training, still trying to pull some stuff together for She in Parallel. Then I got this one-year-old who just is a whole personality of his own. So we are busy. Yeah,
absolutely.
We are absolutely busy.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to figure it out.
Funny story. Can I mess with your mic a little bit?
My God. Yo, right. He has been getting on my nerves today.
There you go.
Leave the mic alone. Go ahead.
Yeah. Hey, look. Got my first COVID test today.
Oh, yeah.
First COVID test. Didn't know what to expect. Heard crazy stories.
For the record, nobody has symptoms, nothing like that. We were just doing it just for precautionary measures because between my high school and doing CTAB, it was just makes sense to do our due diligence to ensure that we are good. While we're around,
man, you gotta
all these
do
people.
No disclaimer.
I just want people to know.
Hey, man,
it's
you took a test.
For one, two, and it's good for business. People are like, oh, you know, they're doing a great job. See, now you do too much. Quiet. Go ahead about your story.
Hey, so they stuck that joint all the way up there, eyes watering, everything, man. It was violated a little bit, man. But now I know the test came back negative. I feel good, man. Just to know, you know what I mean? Just to know, you take the test, man. I highly suggest. Anybody take the test just so you know. You know what I mean?
He's so dramatic. He was teared up and everything in the car. I was like, it is not that deep.
Yo, that joint was about that long, yo.
Oh, my
God. It was,
bruh.
Though, for real.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes, it was.
So extra. Anyways, outside of that coat, back to my dance-off that I was doing before you came in this whole COVID crap. Listen, I need y'all to tell me what is your favorite challenge right now. It's funny how... everybody utilizing internet right now and social media.
Yeah, they doing a heck of a job with that joint.
Most challenges. Some of them be very entertaining. I won't lie. I find myself scrolling, and next thing I know, 25 minutes and rolled by.
More like 60.
Looking at these darn challenges.
Hey, them joints, man.
They
be funny. They creative, too, man. Like, you got to have a lot of time on your hands to be doing it. It's almost like a job, though. You think about it.
Yeah,
like,
if you're getting paid for it.
Yeah, Instagram paying for, you know what I mean, especially if you're getting a following, you're getting views and stuff like that.
Right.
But it's funny, you know what I mean? And the crazy part about it is, too, once they start doing these challenges, it blows the song all the way up. Like, that song, that one joint, you know what I mean?
Is just going, playing.
Yeah, that joint is going crazy.
Y'all know. Real quick. Oh, can I get it? Can I run it back? I don't know if I can run it back that quick.
Let's show it to him.
Huh?
Let's show it to him.
No, this one is not. Go ahead. You can show them the video. Oh, my bitch, bullshit. Ready to get it started. Bitch, I got no sense. Oh, hit a plug. Ride around with fuck. Call me a COVID. Excuse the languages. He ain't give you no disclaimer. I was trying to get a disclaimer.
Listen, why I gotta be a disclaimer about everything?
Because it's not
it. Yeah, I understand that, but that is. We ain't had time to edit it. You know what I mean?
So back to the disclaimer.
Yeah.
As you can tell, he is working my nerves today.
It's one of them days. I'm just saying, man. 2021, man. We ain't apologize for that, man. We'll be who we are.
Darn days today. Anyways.
Yeah, man. Forget all that.
Back. I thought you was about to hit the clap or something. I was about to say, bro.
I ain't messing with it.
But back to these challenges. Yes, there's some dope challenges going on. Which actually it's funny because I wish my brother, they had if we had all this stuff back then between him and his boys, the stuff that they used to do, yeah. You know, I'd be very curious to see if they would actually probably be some social media superstars easy.
Yeah, for sure.
They even got award. They got award shows and everything for all these people and stuff like that.
So you can just wake up in the morning and cut your phone on and do something that you do crazy. Anyway and pop off. Shoot. Got all the HD quality and all that, man. It's crazy.
It is. It is very, very mm-hmm. crazy. But then outside of that, what else has been going on? Oh, I know. I need you guys. Listen, okay? I'm in a dilemma.
Uh-oh.
It has Uh-oh. Been going to be a year since we have traveled anywhere.
Yeah. It been a year for real?
Jamaica was the last place we've been to in March.
True that. True
for
that.
My birthday. Now, background story is everybody who knows, people who know me knows I love to travel, right? Especially on my birthday. That is my birthday month is the one time of the year where I'm mad selfish, okay? It's about me. It's my birthday. The one thing that I have that's mine. Nobody else
and
has.
And she made it a point. To go out the country every single year. How did that start? Give them the backstory because
I've
you started doing
that
about like.
No. I've done that. I did that before you. So I didn't go out the country before I met you. I would travel like literally. That's what my parents gave me. My parents would give me money for my tickets to go wherever I wanted to go. So I was in Miami.
So that's a thing now. That's a
thing. I was in California, LA with friends and all that stuff. So I was always traveling. Then I had a baby. Then it took a little hiatus. Then I told you, yo, I got to get back to my roots. I get it from my mom. So my mom travels all the time. She used to travel her when she was younger, too. Ever since I was 18, I was out.
Right.
Japan, everything. All been everywhere.
All
right. So fast forward to now getting married to Darryl. Took a couple years, and I say, yo, I got to get back on it. So my birthday is just going to have to be the travel time. Like, I have to travel. It's got to travel. We got to figure out somewhere to go. Preferably, I like to be somewhere hot.
Water.
And water.
Blue water.
I don't even got to be in the water. I'm not a water person anyway, but I like blue water, beautiful scenery. That's what I like. And it's got to be hot because I hate the cold. So that's where we've been going. So we've been to, well, we went to Aruba for our honeymoon, which was happened to be in March,
mm-hmm.
even though our anniversary is in December. Aruba, Costa Rica, Bermuda, Bahamas. Where else we been? Jamaica last year.
Yeah, I'm starting to lose count, man.
So I'm supposed to be going to Mexico, trip paid, everything. And then the CDC decided to come out 2 days ago with a whole stipulation of stuff that you got to do when you go out of the country. So we have a travel agent that runs our stuff for us. And she calls and said, hey, just want to let you know before we continue to move forward with this, CDC is saying in order for us to get on the plane to come back home, we have to have a negative COVID test. Now, the issue is in these countries, the tests can range between $100, $150 to up to like $400-something per person. So you're looking at if wherever we were going to Mexico, where were we going? Cabo San Lucas.
Yeah, Cabo.
Cabo. If we were looking at if they, what's the name, hit us with a $400, that's $800 that we come out of pocket just to take a darn test to get onto the plane. When we got back to the States, we had to take another test 5 days later, and we have to quarantine. Yo,
for 7 days, right?
Yeah, for 7 days. Yo, that's a lot.
Yeah, that's a lot.
To be doing just to travel for 4 days out the country.
Right, right.
So, needless to say, I put a plea of help on Facebook because I just needed to know, like, is it worth it or should I just hold it? So, we don't lose out on our money. We can essentially hold our money and use it next year for my birthday, or we can go somewhere domestic. Mm-hmm. The problem with the whole domestic thing is instead of going to an all-inclusive resort, which we were going to, yo, the whole spot that we were going to, my best friend put me on. I had seen the pictures, the videos. I was ready. That's why I have been working so hard to try to figure something out with this bathing suit. It's thick or not, I'm been
talking about it every day, y'all.
Somebody's beach, right? And now I'm looking at spots here in the U.S. and I'm like, and my agent's like, yeah, U.S. doesn't have any all-inclusive stuff. So you'll just pretty much be paying for a hotel and your room. And
yeah. But you still be away, though. You still be away from the crib. Still yeah, get a man, chance to now, kick back and now, I mean, yeah, enjoy yourself. Which part,
because you know. Y'all know Florida's a hot spot, and it's a Trump state. And I'm just trying to tell you, ain't nobody got time for all this foolishness that's going on. People barging up in the Capitol. Listen.
Right.
So I need to know Facebook. I'm talking to my best friends and my family and my sissy, and half everybody's like, just stay home and figure something out here. Other people say, just go and be safe. Which, you know, you can't move in fear.
You know what you're going to do, man. You know what I mean?
I mean, my heart is telling me to go ahead and carry my hind parts and be about my business. Because, it's a whole year. We're not going nowhere, like, legit. Like, if we don't go in March, you already know my burnout is right now. This is normally the burnout because AAU season starts back up. So burnout meaning I go hard right now because this is high school season. So I'm 6 days a week high school at CTAB, got training 3 days a week. Got everything else, right. Mommy duty, wifey duties, everything.
Hey, gotta get it, man. It's the year we in.
So usually between the February, March time frame is my, okay, I'm hitting that brink. Let's take that breather. And then now I'm good for AAU season. We rolling.
Yeah.
Just like last year. That's why I went to Jamaica. But now you're telling me we might be sitting right here in D.C. looking at everybody.
Yeah, we ain't gonna be in D.C. We'll be somewhere, man. You know what I mean? I got you, man. It's hold tight.
I don't want to be in the United States of America.
Hey, man. Especially times like this, man. It was just crazy.
I know,
man.
It's all this foolishness.
Yeah. But look, other news.
My mom said, my mother-in-law said she'll just send me a bowl of hot water and stay home. All right, Miss B. Anyways.
James Harden.
Before we get to James Harden, please, somebody, y'all, I just want to hear people's input. Y'all go to my Facebook page, Lee Tao, and you can see my comments. So I'm just curious to see what everybody says.
Yeah, man.
I'll let y'all know by tomorrow what my decision is. Proceed.
Don't hold your breath, man. Proceed. She going somewhere. James Harden. Now, everybody keep talking about the trade. What is it going to do? They're going to be a championship team. They're going to win. This is my take on it. My man will never be a winner, man, unless he passed the ball. Unless he plays defense. I feel like he's toxic right now to any team that he go to. It's going to be very hard for him to go to any team, let alone with two of the best scorers in the game right now with Kyrie and KD.
Did you mention that? You mentioned he got traded to Brooklyn. I don't know if you said that.
If you didn't know, we're talking about James Harden, who got traded to the Brooklyn Nets.
Why do they have him in the front?
It's all about marketing. It's all about promotion, man. He is about to kill that chemistry of that team.
Yeah, he is, because he's selfish. He's a brat.
That is about to be a bad situation. It ain't enough balls, man, for one team, man. You know what I mean? At the end of the day. So it's going to be a bad situation. I hope it go good for KD and Kyrie, man. But that wouldn't be my pick. I would have kept Jared Allen. They gave away one of the biggest guys, is a shot blocker and defender. They gave him up. Mm. It's crazy. Well, it's going to be a tough one, man. You know what I mean? I don't like it. But at the end of the day, I'm not a GM.
Sure,
you know what I mean?
None of that coming over here.
So, good luck
to all y'all Brooklyn fans.
Yeah, salute to y'all.
I will say the positive thing of Brooklyn is the stadium is a dope stadium. Remember when we went?
Mm-hmm.
I would think we went the first year that they built it.
Yeah, it's tough.
Or built it out. That's a nice little stadium.
Definitely a nice that's environment. Good, but the decision making on picking James Harden is trash.
You got your button.
I ain't messing with the buttons because you always saying something. I bring it out in the right time.
He's emotional. Anyways, what's our topic for today? What are we talking about?
The topic of today is boundaries and access.
What does that mean? What are you talking about?
Boundaries, man. Like setting boundaries, whether it's setting guidelines for people to have access to you, man. Like, you know what I mean? Whether it's on social media, whether it's a family member, whether it's, you know what I mean, friends and business partners, man, at the end of the day. Like, we give too much access to people. And one thing that come to mind, and you used to talk about it all the time, which is a great topic of friends. Mm-hmm. Is it appropriate to have friends that's the same sex as you?
Do you mean you know opposite mean? Sex of you?
Yeah, opposite sex. My bad. Opposite sex. You know what I mean? Like, is that possible?
That's a whole another
in itself
topic in itself.
You want to save that?
I mean, we can talk about it. You done brought it up now. Now people gonna be wondering what our opinion is on it.
Nah, we'll say that. That's one in itself. It. You know what I mean? But talking about, I know for me personally, thinking about it is giving people too much access and not setting boundaries on how you get a hold of me. You know what I mean? I'm talking about especially now, like it's too easy. And a lot of times you leave room for people to take advantage of you, to throw their own will on you and things like that. So right now I made it a point in 2021 to set boundaries and not give access to everybody.
I agree. And I disagree.
What do you disagree on? Talk to me.
No, I gotta let him marinate for a second. Well, you can keep talking. I mean, so when you talk, okay, so when we talk about boundary, yes, I through experience, I have learned that, so like we've talked about it many times before, how I'm very open, very honest, wear my heart on my sleeve. If you connect with me, I'm going all out and above and beyond most of the time. And I have experienced that. Being like that can have consequences because people take advantage of your heart and your kindness. And if things don't go the way that they want, they'll turn on you in a heartbeat. And mm-hmm. In my mindset, I'm like the old adage says, you know, treat others the way you want to be treated. So if I'm coming out and giving you kindness and love and serving you essentially, my expectation would be that's what I get in return. But the reality of the fact is people don't think the way that I think. People right. don't live the way that I think. People don't move the way that I move. And it took a couple of smacks in the face to understand that no matter what I do, people are going to be who they are mm-hmm. from what their expectations of life is. And it's nothing wrong with being who I am, but I have to understand that they're not me.
Right, right, absolutely.
And so with that being said, I think that's lessons that a lot of us have to learn, and I think that's where you cultivate different boundaries at the adult level.
Right, right.
But growing up, I mean, your boundaries were, you know, adults don't cross lines with kids, that kind of stuff.
Right,
but
right.
We're talking about boundaries at the adult level.
Yeah. But I mean, that's one of the things I'm talking about too. And also who you giving access to, being careful and selective, you know, on who you give that time to. You know what I mean? If you go through your phone or, you know, through your text and through your contact list, everybody on that list or through your text message should be something of value, whether it's just, you know, encouraging each other, whether it's like a business, you sharing ideas, whether you sharing each other, sending each other scriptures or sermons. I know, you know what I mean? A few of my partners, you know what I mean? I don't do this with everybody because everybody is not on that same level or page or understanding. You know, we share, you know, prayers and stuff like that. I remember one time, you know, recently going up to a big meeting and working on a project. And, you know, I had a whole 3 hours to drive. And next thing you know, I get a text, you know, from a partner of mine just praying for me and really speaking encouraging words. These are the people that in 2021 I choose to give access to.
That's true. But you never know if you don't give people trials, if you don't give people opportunities. Because I think a lot of times, too, and this goes back to when we were talking about when people date. Sometimes you cut people off who you haven't even given a chance to or an opportunity to show who they are.
Right.
So it's kind of hard to really create boundaries. So I think there might be a stipulation that you put initially, like, how do I say it? Like, for one, you know, I know I'm not going to go this far when I first initially meet somebody, they have to show me something before I really open up doors.
Right.
But I think you still got to give people opportunities mm-hmm. to do something, you know, to prove who they are.
I agree. That was my next thing. Like, and it is some people out there that need more access to you that you don't even think about. Like, it's always somebody there that's trying to support you or want to help or will be adding value to your life. But sometimes you don't even, like you said, reach out to them or give them that opportunity. And I know I can think of a couple of people who are like, you know what, man, I need to hang out with this person more. I need to talk to this person more, or things like that might add value to my life and I add value to them.
But I think at the same time, God will place those necessary people. Like, if somebody you might think needs to have quote unquote more access to you, but if they haven't, if the line hasn't been made or that relationship hasn't been made, that just means it's not timing. Because at the same right. the same thing time, there's perfect timing in everything. So what you mm-hmm. might think needs to be a relationship today isn't what God had for you today.
Facts.
Right. Mm-hmm. So that might be a future relationship that's going to be built when he's ready for that to happen. But right now it's not for you to create, because then at the same time, you also got to think about balance.
Right.
So you think A, B, C, and D need to have access to you because y'all can all thrive off of, you know, relationship, business, mentorship, all that stuff. But then your children over here need more access than A, B, C, and D. Yeah. So how are you going to balance who's more important?
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I think those are, that's, for me, that's what it comes down to. For me, I love everybody. But at the end of the day, I'm dropping anything for mm-hmm. my household, period.
Right.
Don't care what it is. Don't care if it's millions. If something that my household needs my time and attention before any and anybody else, then that's what I'm going to focus on. Because at the end, I don't ever want to get to a situation where I'm here and when you ask them, how was mom or husband-wise, how was your wife? It's like, she worked hard. You know, she worked hard. She wasn't really here, but she worked hard.
Right.
I don't
ever
want my kids to look at me at that or my household to look at me like that. So for me, I think my boundaries are based with my family.
Right, for sure. Why do you think it's so hard for some people to create that balance?
I don't know. Why is it so hard for you to create the balance?
I don't know. Why is it so hard?
That's a good question. I'm saying. I mean, I think it's about vision. I think it's about aspirations. I think it's about background. So, like, for example, from my household, I saw my father and my mother on a regular basis, even though they worked hard, because they definitely grind and they definitely got an immaculate home, relationship, presence in the community, all that good stuff.
Right.
So how they maintain their balance, I don't know. I just know from my vision, what I saw, I could take a piece of what I saw to implement it in my household. And I know my decision is, no matter what's going on, this is what is important to me. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the details of how they made their work, you know, they could have, you know, my father could have worked way more and mom was just home and I just didn't see all that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I saw enough to know, okay, I want success, but I want a family, you know, and for me, and I think it's also contentment. So for me, my contentment, right now I'm still grinding, you know, I still grind, I want to get, but when I officially get my own home and got enough money in my pocket to last me a lifetime to continue, where I don't have to penny pinch on a weekly basis, right? I'm good. Now, would I love to go beyond? Sure. But if it's going to take me away from my current situation, I'm not pressed, because at that point, I've hit a good, now I want to be able to go to my kids' games. I want to make sure that they're doing everything. You know what I mean?
And travel when you want.
Travel when I want, right. But if I'm constantly, and I think that, and I think I was just talking to somebody about that, about how sometimes people say, oh, I want this, but then you're constantly chasing after the next thing. At what point is it enough?
Right.
Like you can't, you doing all this chasing and grasping and everything, but then at what point is it like, yo, all right, you done got it. When are you gonna enjoy it? And that's it.
In the presence.
Yes. When are you gonna be in the moment and enjoy your moment instead of constantly chasing the next thing?
Right, right. That's one of the things I said too in 2021 is finding boundaries. If I'm gonna do, you know, a project and, you know, I'm supposed to be done at 4 o'clock, I'm gonna try to be done at 4 o'clock. That's what 2021, that's what I'm supposed to do. If I'm gonna work on this project, I need, you know, 5 hours, I expect them 5 hours. But when it's time to be done, I wanna be done and not a minute over. You know what I mean? At the end of the day. And I think for real, you know, from people that are coming from different backgrounds, it's hard. Especially if you never had anything, you don't know when enough is enough. You know what I mean? Because if you never had anything, you want the best of the best. You know what I mean? And I think that's how a lot of people think. Mm-hmm. Like, yo, I want everything I never had before. You know what I'm saying? And once you get a taste of it, you know, you just keep going. It's like some people are addicted to the success. They're addicted to the process. They're addicted to the grind, especially if you come from a certain area and then you go through the process and then you get it. It's different, you know what I'm saying?
But so, I would also think that you would I would think that you would appreciate those moments because you came from a background where you didn't have and you had to learn to enjoy
absolutely
what you didn't have.
Yeah.
So now that you get, I mean, it's like when you go out when you're young and you go out and you actually buy your own first pair of shoes, like. Mm-hmm. Came out of your pocket, you earned the money, you bought these and you never had them and you finally went through that process of earning money and going to the store and purchasing your own joints, like, for me, I can only speak for myself, for me, that's like the moment of, all right, I'm good, now I got me a fresh pair of kicks. But there's so many people who now get their kicks and they put on their feet, they're like, yes, all right, let me get the next best ones, instead of like, yo, you just got these joints. Enjoy these joints for that moment. So that's what I'm saying. Like, if you coming from number struggling backgrounds, like, at what point do you remember where you came from and enjoy your moment?
Yeah, absolutely. I got to do that often. Sometimes when I come down here, you don't see me. Like, I sit down on this couch, and I got to take myself, be like, yo. Because me and nephew were talking about it. I was like, yo, I came a long way, man. Mm-hmm. Like, to sit, you know what I mean, to be down here, to even have the opportunity to record a podcast with dope equipment and have a space and books, nice books to read, and you know what I mean, go upstairs to the fam and then go to another level to your bed, like to sit back and like, yo, this is all right, man. God is working. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of times when you're in the grind, you're in the process, you forget about those things, man. But if you take that moment, you be intentional about really being in the presence. Mm-hmm. And creating these boundaries. And a boundary, too, could be having that space alone. Don't let nobody interfere with your peace and your space, your time. Because we all need time. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, we be going through the day so giving people so much, whether it's to a spouse, or whether to the kids, whether it's to your family, your friends. When is the time that you have to yourself and be like, yo, this is my time before anybody, before any emails? And that's another thing, too, you know, that I'm trying to get into. Like, get in tune to yourself and into, you know, to God before anybody else.
Well, that's why you're supposed to do. Best time is during the day. I mean, when you first wake up in the morning. Right. That's why they say put your slippers all in it. Well, if you wear, so I wear slippers every day. So you got slippers. Put your slippers on underneath your bed so you can reach down and get on your hands and knees and pray. Essentially, you're getting your slippers, but you're praying first.
Right.
So I think that's the best time. And even if it's 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it's the best and most humbling time to center your focus, one, and get your mind prepared for that day.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you wake up, which – you know, we've had conversation where sometimes the first thing on your mind is with business. And it's like, yo, take a moment. You just woke up. Like, God just woke you up.
Literally just woke up.
Like, yo, take a yawn, stretch, crinkle your toes, something. But some people, you know, Daryl used to be in that habit. You wake up and be like, yo, we got to do this CT. And I'd be like, bro, first of all, I'm not a morning person. So I don't care who I was with, if I was ever in a business or not in a business. I'm not a morning person, period. My daddy knows, like.
Do not talk to this woman early in the morning.
I'm not grouchy. I just don't talk. Like, my parents would tell you, when I wake up, my daddy will always say, good morning.
Stank face.
And I go.
Like, head nod.
Because I don't talk. Good morning. I think I was like around my adulthood when I started saying good morning. Now I do it.
I think it's when you got with me before you wanted. Is you going to say good morning or something? Yo. They give me no head nod.
Oh, my goodness.
Straight hooper.
Well, anyways. So, yes. So, in the morning times, yes, you used to have the moments where it'd be like, we got to do this CTAG. We got. I'd be like, yo, are you serious right now? Like, I just want to look at the ceiling for 5 minutes before I do anything. Slow move. Ceiling, pray. I might pull the sheets back up, lay down, sit for a minute on the edge of the bed, go walk to the bathroom, come out.
Right.
Woosah. Now you got to put a little pep in your step now because the kids be running in there and it's like, oh.
You got to get everything done before
I'm
they wake
hungry.
Up.
I'm hungry. It's like, oh. Thank God. See, I will say blessings is TT is 10. You just, go down and make some breakfast.
Right.
That is like the best feeling in the world.
Zay need to hurry up and get this.
Shoot, you ain't never lie. Go make some cereal, bro.
Right.
But, them type of boundaries, those are important. Self-focused.
Mm-hmm.
Making sure you're good, because again, if you don't pour into yourself, how are you gonna pour into others?
Right, absolutely.
I mean, my self focus when I go get my nails done, I don't talk to them, the people doing my nails, nothing. I got my headphones on, I'm listening to whatever sermon. Right.
Mm-hmm.
They ask me questions.
Gotta get in the moment, man. You know what I mean? And that's super important, man. And that's one of the things that we talk about daily, man, and we got to continue to grow, got to continue to do these things and protect our peace, protect our boundaries, man. But at the same time, we're talking about access. Another thing that I think about, too, is God granting us access to his word and to the path that he got for us, you know what I mean? Right. A lot of times we don't think about that, you know what I mean? Like how many opportunities and blessings that are in front of us that we don't even recognize. You know what I mean? Like, he's granting us access to his holy blessings, but a lot of times we like, man, we don't recognize it. We don't either take it when it's available to us, or we don't recognize it, you know what I mean, when he's putting it blatantly in front of us.
So I think it's also having discernment, right? So part of being able to access these blessings and stuff sitting right in front of you. So, I mean, just as simple as little things like I think about all the time when I think about just this past year alone for us running our own business. So CTAB is big and it's becoming a household name, but it's nowhere to the magnitude of one to two other programs in our area, right?
Right.
It's right there. But it was big enough to be able to allow us to sustain for a whole year without having, and when I tell you, like, if you looked at our numbers compared to 2019 compared to 2020, like, I think business cut down almost to a quarter, if that, at one point.
Yep.
And even now, we're probably operating at essentially 50-65% because we don't have space, because everything's shut down, because we gotta be strategic. But I think about the different blessings. So I think about just this month alone, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, we've had to rent out other facilities that have been overbooked in order to continue to run our own organization. And this month, we have been blessed with an opportunity to get a spot that just happened to just align with what I'm already doing. Like,
right,
it just...
Right.
And it was so, and it literally, it happened within a week's time span because it was December.
Yeah.
And I'm looking at D like, yo, we don't have nowhere to train next week.
Mm-hmm.
And everything just manifests. And it was like, yo.
Yeah.
And we're big on recognizing moments like that. Like, dang.
Yeah.
Yo, that is a blessing, because any other time, mm-hmm. we could have been struggling. But because we are connected and we are faithful to our word, things like this arise. And that's why I think we're so big. And I know many people might, you know, tune in and many people might see us or meet us. And they always hear what we say. Yo, the only reason why we talk like this is because through experience. This is not somebody telling us this is how you're supposed to be. This is hands down experience that has allowed us to manifest to the mindset like, yo, this is the only thing that the only way and the only reason why I think that we have been able to sustain to where we are at this point. And so it's just those are those blessings, like you said. Don't recognize your blessing, but to the discernment aspect is when you're tuned in to your divine nature and that dominance of what God is doing for your life. You also have the discernment to know that all these great opportunities are not always the best opportunities for you in that moment. So many people see so many opportunities like, yo, oh, this is coming. Just because it's an opportunity doesn't mean it's the right one.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? Like, and I think that's where a lot of people get confused with, well, it's here, I need to take it. Well, just because it's here doesn't mean that it's necessary for you, because you could bite off more than you could chew. Even though it's here at this moment, it's not ready for you to take. It's just almost like a appetizer just for you to see, which is the possibilities. But take them baby steps before you take this, so that you can have a stronger foundation to be able to sustain it.
Yeah, and that's facts, man. Because I could think about last year, top of the year, working on like a day in the life of a student athletes, and that was kind of like a seed that was planted, and then during the course of that time, you know, thinking about to work on a project with a prestige athlete. With a big name back in the day, and we like, yeah, man, we about to do this documentary, we pushing forward, but everything didn't align. It wasn't aligned, like, you know what I mean? The schedule was in line, it was a lot of running around. I'm like, man, something just ain't right, you know what I'm saying? It just wasn't.
And then you had some praying women up in that camp too that was trying to let you know. Shout out to my homie, she knows who she is.
Yeah, we're like, yo, something ain't right, man. This joint is off. So, long story short, the project, you know, kind of had to fall back. But then as soon as it decided to fall back,
something bigger came about.
Something bigger, way bigger, like 20 times bigger came to life. Like, yo, it's so big, I can't even imagine, like, that I'm really working on this joint. Like, it's really, you know what I mean? Because a lot of times you talk about stuff, you want stuff to happen, and we talked about it in other episodes. When it's, like, finally here, like, yo, I really got to, you know what I mean? About to do this thing, you know what I'm saying? So, like, to go back to your point, yo, a lot of times we can be rushing something or thinking something is our time, but God just be nudging it off, like, yo, back up, don't touch that yet, you know what I'm saying? And he'll throw something on you where it's going to be seamless, it's going to be effortless, it's going to be a lot of things to be lined up. So the project we're working on now, like it's moving smooth, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's crazy. So now I got to create boundaries with my schedule. Well, I got to get my calendar right.
Well, a calendar that for 10 years I have been trying to show, teach. I think I done bought you about 100 different notebooks and calendars. As of this week, the light bulb finally went off. So those of y'all who are young wives like myself, who y'all just trying to figure out, listen, it's going to take time, okay? You just keep planting that seed, sowing that seed into your husband's spirit, and pray that it will harvest.
Right, but look, though. But the thing is, like, back when you was telling me that, it was...
You being hard-headed?
No. It was stuff going on, but it ain't like now. Like, now is, like, real, because it's really real work and really opportunities, real opportunities, and everything is coming. I'm like, yo, I got to. Like, it's forcing me to do it.
Right. And but it was the seed was planted preparation for this process.
Right, absolutely.
So you would have jumped on it early, it'd have been a smooth sailing thing now.
Yeah.
But now you got to sit here and try, I pay you to come and help help me pull this together, master. Listen, I told you 10 years ago, you need to be rolling right now with these darn agendas and stuff.
Yeah, you're right. You know what I mean? But timing is everything to process. And I mean, now I understand the significance and importance of being organized, setting boundaries, and doing things like that, man. So shout out to you, man, for holding it down.
Appreciate that. So let's get back to that one comment you said about boundaries with the opposite sex. I want to know where you was going with that one.
I'm just saying a lot of people out there in the world just saying it's difficult to do to be in a relationship with the opposite sex, being friends.
I totally
agree. Know what I mean? And some people say it's possible. Some people say it's not. So for our viewers, what do you think? Y'all can leave a comment below. You know what I mean? Hop on. What do you think? Is it possible for a man and a female to be just friends without anything happening?
So here's my whole take on the whole thing.
Okay.
You can have friendships with the opposite sex if so, and it depends on your relationship status. So for us, how we operate, if there is a female or a male that I am friends with, it is important for me to ensure that this man knows that this is my husband and that there is a connection there or a relationship, essentially, not besties, but they know who each other are.
Right.
I would never have a male friend that you don't know about.
Right.
And I think that's where the issues lie, whereas if you have these friendships with people that your significant other doesn't know about, and then if you do have friends who cross lines, I would think that you would take it upon yourself to remove that person before it gets any worse, or whoever your significant other finds out or hears about it, because then it's going to be even worse than what it needs to be.
Right. No, I 100% agree.
That's my number one. Mm-hmm. But then also is...
But not, hold on, not because... A lot of men don't know, though.
A lot of men don't know, and I was one of them.
Like, I always been a type, even not even just with women, with men. You know what I mean? Like, boys, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like if we grew up, or, you know what I mean, and it always been cool, or, you know, we shared experiences together, you know what I mean, it's like forever.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I ain't, you know, didn't know how that could affect in a relationship. Now, obviously, you know, if boundaries have been crossed, you know, during a relationship or whatever, I understand that, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, it's all different types of ways to think of it, you know what I mean? And that's how some men think.
So the part that I was about to highlight was the fact that a lot of times, like you said, y'all men, even females, can be naive to relationships and see certain behaviors where we can see. So, you know, there could be a female, like, say, perfect example. Where was we at? We were in the Bahamas.
It wasn't the Bahamas.
Yes, it was. We was in the Bahamas, and this young lady, even though she was in her own situation, when she came around Daryl, it was always, ah, ta, ta. Wait, we don't, that's my husband. I don't know you like that. We are not doing that. No, we don't touch. This is Lee Tao territory. That's it. We don't do that. And you gotta check people. Thank you. Yep.
That's what I'm saying. But it could have just been innocent.
Because people have intentions. Right. So the innocence could be that she's not gonna completely cross borders, but she's naturally a flirt. So she. Whereas me as a female, and I can peep that.
Right.
Oh, no, shorty, listen, we don't, in this household, we don't do that, okay? Thank you very much.
So you thought it was something?
She was definitely flirting, hands down. I told you that. I thought that whole thing was shut down.
Said,
What do you mean? No, shut down.
That lets you know how men and women can be naive, because I had no clue. That's just, you know, it might be a personality or whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Just dumb. No, I'm just kidding. No, and it could be on the flip side, you know. Dudes could do the same thing. I mean, I'm around dudes all the time because I hoop. So ain't no telling. You could be a dude, come, slam dunk, and you could go look at it and be like.
Yeah. It was a situation. One Thanksgiving.
First of all, but here's the funny thing about that.
My man, what was you thinking about?
Here's the funny thing about that evening. Listen.
About to flip this whole house over.
Everybody in the house peeped. So it wasn't like I was dumb. I peeped. I removed myself. My brother peeped. My sister peeped. Everybody was like, skirt.
Yeah, he was tipsy. Yeah, he had them in. My awareness
was like, yo, my antenna. And I felt, the minute I felt something, I felt burning on this side. I said, oh, yep. And me and my brother had to say, hoo-doo. Yo, I'll let your peoples, yo. And it was him.
That was blatant, though.
Huh?
I think that was blatant. No, it wasn't.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah,
no,
he was a little bit on the tip. Well, a lot on the tipsy side.
So it wasn't blatant.
Yeah, so, you know.
But your girl was. So let it be known it was shut down. So anyways, back to the point at hand. No, I personally do not think that you can. Because, I mean, I think we've all at some point in our lives have fallen to relationships and issues where you just don't,
right,
shouldn't be involved in, or comments or conversations and all that kind of stuff. So if your male friend or your female friend can't have a platonic relationship with your significant other, then I don't see why there should be a friendship.
I agree.
Because it can get messy. I mean, and that's why, like, you know, people, past people, stuff like that. Like, sometimes people just say stuff just to see reactions
where you're at right now.
And you just look, I just listen. For me, just try to avoid it, because you don't want to get yourself in a situation. You don't want your spouse. You know, we don't need to have a first 48. Like,
first 48, though.
Just don't do that. So,
yeah, absolutely. I agree. And that could be a segment in itself, though. I think we should bring in another couple to talk about that.
Like, who? Most people would be on the same page, I would think. It's very
different opinions, though.
Right,
man,
and the people, but the people. It's funny though. It's funny you said that, because the people who do be like, "Nah, you can," is the same ones I can see. Yup, because if I slid in your DMs, you probably would sit there and entertain me.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? So you can tell people's character a lot. And like I said, we're all not perfect. None of us is perfect. Daryl and I are not perfect. Nothing like that. But we're intentional about what we do. Right. So if I know for a fact that if I get to talking to somebody and I know it could get reminiscent and stuff like that from Pat, I'm not going to mess with it, because I don't want to get in that mindset. Because it's very easy. And, you know, in a marriage, people think that just because you married, you locked in. No, just like we were talking about before.
It's an
everyday
battle.
It's every day. You could see somebody, you could a song, a video, whatever. So instead of sitting there and indulging or entertaining that moment, which could turn into a lifetime of hurt.
Right.
Stiff arm it. Just stiff arm it. It was what it was. They didn't make it to your present. Enjoy your moment. Enjoy. If you got something good, enjoy it and keep it. Because then on top of that, if you have little ones, they seeing. So if they see daddy out here, and that's the one thing I will tell you about CT, that boy's a snitch.
Yeah,
I love it. That thing would tell in a heartbeat. Yo, this lady was talking to daddy.
He tried to pin me for something.
You be quiet. Who was it? What did she look like? Oh, yeah. She did? Okay. And she said what? Oh,
right.
Okay.
All the deets. Bro, you trying to pin me for a case. I ain't even. Total innocent.
But the point that matters is the fact that your kids see everything. So everything you think that you're hiding, somebody is peeping, period. So either they're going to reenact what they see, or if they Tweety Bird like mine, they just going to tell it. And right. I love it.
Right, right. Shoot. I think the other thing, too, is we talk about when we talk about boundaries and access, what are you allowing in your mind that is crossing boundaries? I think even, too, like with movies, like watching certain movies and, you know, we talked about, too, you know what I mean, watching Real Love and Hip Hop and all these crazy shows where it's fighting and a lot of, you know what I mean?
Right into a whole history.
Yeah, a lot of sex and a lot of cheating and a lot of throwing drinks and stuff like that can really corrupt your mind and allowing them. You got to have boundaries with this stuff, you know what I mean? And, you know, even to think about, too, you know what I'm saying? I remember a couple of episodes, I ain't never tell nobody this, you know what I mean? Or tell you this.
Oh, Jesus.
You know what I mean? Watching certain shows, it was a lot of action going on, you know? And then later on, you know,
I wish I could do a zoom in. You can't do a zoom in?
You was high. You was high and ready, you know what I mean?
Do a zoom in on it.
So that just, you know, things like that, I'm like, oh, man. So you got to watch what you put in your mind. That's long story short, you know what I mean?
But you also got to be strong. Like, if you're not, so, I mean, it's just like, what is that darn scripture? But it's also like for if you were an alcoholic, and mm-hmm. I know for a fact, you know that you're an alcoholic and you go to a party, you're trying to get over it, but you right. go to a party where you know there's going to be alcohol. Why put yourself in them type of situations? If you're not strong enough, you don't need to be there, because therein lies that temptation.
Right.
So that's the same thing with, like you said, with your putting into your mind. If you know for a fact that you have, you know, lustful issues that you got to deal with, or if you've been heartbroken and are angry woman, and then you're going to sit here and watch Loving Hip Hop. Take that back. Loving
You don't
want
to watch the show.
Loving Hip Hop.
You don't want to watch the show.
Right. You take Loving Hip Hop, and then you hot about stuff that's right. happening. Like, you... Yeah. You can't watch stuff you can't be in environments if you're not strong enough to handle it.
A lot of times we was watching that joint, you looking at me like this.
Oh, yeah.
Side eye and all that. I'm like, can't watch this done.
Again,
for
me, I learn quick. Like, I learn lessons very quickly. If I mess up, I don't want to repeat it. I don't like, that's how I was as a kid. I got in trouble. Very rarely would I repeat anything that I got in trouble for.
Right.
So when I started figuring out, me watching this stuff was going to get into my spirit and my mindset, and then I was going to be irritated with you, I said, yo, I can't do it.
So is that why you stopped watching it? Because you definitely...
That just made sense. It doesn't make sense. Because
I noticed. I'm like, hold on, she ain't...
Because I don't make sense.
Yeah, so. That's for sure, man. Definitely got to create them boundaries and, allow and don't allow people or things to corrupt your mind. You know what I mean?
Right.
At the end of the day.
Right. Agreed.
Yep. Yeah, y'all.
Well, I think that was a juicy topic.
Yeah, we got to follow up, man. We had to get a couple up here and, you know, a couple of other people weighing their opinion, man. I think a lot of people want to know more about that topic. You know what I'm saying?
What we got? We got some comments. Yeah. Comments. Let's look at these comments real quick before we close out in the next 2 minutes.
Oh, yeah. With the social media being accessible to all ages, temptation is accessible. Spend that time talking with family.
So I think that right there is the game changer in this generation, this time frame, is social media.
Right.
Because that right there is what breaks relationships. That right there is what is breaking our kids.
Yeah.
When you give them these accesses to this stuff that they can't handle. Like, right. I cannot imagine growing up, like, not even be able to have a conversation with somebody at this point, because I would be so enthralled with what's going on my phone.
Right.
Like, whereas back then, like, I'll tell you, one of the most sweetest moments we ever had.
Uh-oh.
Okay. This was recently, too.
Uh-oh. When you went,
I don't expose you in front of all your Uh-oh. Boys. We went to, he spent 4 days. Where was you? I think it was for the junior phenom. Where was y'all at?
Where?
I don't know. You was gone for 4 days. You and CT.
Anyways, Atlanta?
Yeah, something like that. So anyways, We went old school. We're old school. We text, we talk all the time. Even though we work together all the time. I'm about to embarrass you. That night, one of the nights, we ended up literally talking on the phone and fell asleep. We were FaceTiming and we fell asleep on the phone until the next morning. I woke up and my heart was so like, oh, this was so, it's real. Because how many of y'all at this point in life can say that y'all do that? Like, that was like the thing back then. You know, your friend
right.
fall asleep on the phone.
I didn't know it meant that, you know, I didn't know it was that important to you.
It wasn't, but it was the fact that it just happened genuinely and like, it was real. It was real. It wasn't like we forced it. It was just real like, all
right. Right.
Good night. And next thing I know, I hear looked at the phone, his pillow face all in the pillow. I said, oh. All the way to the morning time. I don't know who hung up the phone because I don't remember either.
Back in the day, that joint was like, man. Whatever joke.
But that right there is like, those missing things are what the kids don't do no more. Like right. now they all sliding in people's DMs and looking at all this and so fast and beyond their years, creating lives that they can't handle.
Right,
and it sucks. But then now you got a relationship. Now relationships are official because on my such and such page, I said we're in a relationship.
Right.
Like, it's not official until you say that we're in a relationship. Right, and it's just, so much now. Like, it's missing the life, and relationships are just missing that authenticity because social media, I feel like, it's just masking reality.
Yeah.
Period.
Nah, hands down.
You see pieces of what life really is.
Yeah.
That's why CT at the age of 10 don't got no cell phone.
Yeah. Nah, I mean, it's real because even thinking about, you know what I mean, him even having an Instagram, we not managing. I mean, we'll manage it, but for him to be on there, all it take is one search or, you know, and it lead to something else.
Right.
That is scary. You know what I'm saying?
It is. Or being around your little fast behind friends. I don't know. Hey, listen, I'm going to tell you right now, if any of y'all's kids hang around our son, we grill the mess out of our child to figure out who's what, saying what, doing what, showing. Because he gets in trouble if he allows himself to be in situations that he's not supposed to be in. Like, but the reason why is because we want him to understand this is not right at this age. Now, if you have questions, he knows whatever that question is.
Yeah, come to us.
Come to us. I'd rather you ask us than to sit here and learn from an inexperienced child. Mm-hmm. Period. So,
shout out.
Anyway, got that off our chest. But, so back to the whole point of today is to ensure that you guys create boundaries.
Yeah.
Limit your access to people. You know, when you're with your family, you should be with your family. Nothing's an emergency. If it ain't on fire, it's not an emergency. It is what it is.
Absolutely.
Focus with your family. Because I'm telling you, at the end of the day, you're going to miss out on times and opportunities that you can't get back.
Hands down.
You were with. Your children or your husband, your wife, whomever.
All that, man. I got that's taken home with a quote that I found by Biggs, Jay-Z partner. You cannot finesse a good person. You only finesse yourself out of having access to them.
That's kind of a catch-22 though, because you can finesse a good person essentially in the beginning, but then the outcome is now you done lost access to something that could have been very positive.
At the end of the day, it's gonna be your loss,
right?
You know what I mean? And that good person, the karma is a beast, you know what I mean? So you lose that access, man, to them, you know, it can be detrimental to your own blessings,
right?
You know, at the end of the day.
And let that be a look, experience straight up. Like, straight up, I will not forget this one situation came full circle where somebody just said wrong about me. And if they didn't come back around, you know,
right,
thanking me for who I am and what I do and whoop-de-whoop-de-whoop and ask me to be a part of something, like, yo, And that moment, right. It hurt, and it was necessary for me as a good person to learn that experience and to recognize it. So now I know how to, like we've been talking about,
yeah, man,
create that, you know, boundary, create different lines of access.
Yeah,
but when you mess with God's anointing, people are gonna figure it out.
Yeah, man,
and they're gonna come full circle at some point. And the ones who don't figure it out, hey, I bet you your life feels a whole lot better without them.
Absolutely, man.
So
you gotta protect that peace, man. Don't let everybody in your circle, man. I'm gonna tell you that right.
Listen,
now I'm about to have a handful. That's it.
I tell all the time. I mean? All the time. Don't I be quick? Nope.
Yeah, that ain't nope. The one. That ain't the
I
one.
I tell him quick. Yeah. Listen, I'm tell you right now. I'm not gonna be. You go ahead. Mm-hmm. When they come, look, I'm gonna be sitting just like him.
For sure. Uh-huh. Hey, we appreciate y'all for tapping in. Hey, look, before we go, we always support our fam. Forgot to do it at the beginning of the show, but shout out to my homegirl, Aisha. You see there, she got the Juice hoodie, you know what I mean, from the movie with Tupac and Omar Epps and everybody. She got a clothing line, Just Tease Me Clothing. Appreciate you, man, and keep making that dope gear.
Yep. We will see y'all. Next week. We got somebody next week?
Yeah, we got Paul Williams and his wife. When is that? They on the 21st. But the next guest we got is Paul Williams and his wife. Amazing couple. He's a mental health therapist. And his wife doing the same thing, man. They're doing amazing work. Can't wait to have him on the show.
For sure.
Yeah, yo.
All right, y'all. It's been real. We will see y'all next week. We need to get a closing, like love, peace, and blessings. Oh, what's the, what's they used to say? Mama, what they used to say?
You so old. So old. Look, she old. Yeah, you so old.
I need to figure out what they used to say. We need a close. We need a close out. Like,
oh, yeah. We'll come up with something. Hey, look, make sure y'all share this podcast, man. Shoot your shot. Hey, that's good though.
Not for them love basketball.
Share this live, y'all. Make sure y'all share it. Give it out there, man. We need more positivity in the world. We need more laughter. We need more love.
Yes. And especially if y'all are in the DMV area, please be safe. We got the inauguration coming up. Ain't no telling what's gonna happen. So please be safe if y'all are out here. Stay home, stay covered up, keep your masks on. Don't be going to a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
The way it's looking, I done got 3 text messages that said, have a birthday dinner and sit down somewhere.
Hey, do that, man. Life is good, man. Y'all keep being blessed.
Peace out, y'all.